Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today's topic is biomedical applications of Nanoceria. Nanoceria has recently received much attention because of its widespread biomedical applications, including antibacterial, antioxidant and anti-cancer activity, drug or gene delivery systems, anti-diabetic property, and tissue engineering. Among various nanoparticles, metal oxide nanoparticles are essential and are widely used nowadays due to their unique properties and a large variety of applications in different fields. Cerium oxide nanoparticles, or nanoceria, are a popular choice among metal oxide nanoparticles because of their diverse range of applications, particularly in the biomedical industry. Cerium is the most abundant rare earth element in the lanthanide class, and it may be found in the crust of the earth. It can be found in both a trivalent and a tetravalent form. Cerium is stable in both the trivalent and tetravalent states, whereas other lanthanide elements are only stable in the trivalent form. Nanoceria is the most critical rare earth metal oxide because of its unique ability to transition between +3 and +4 oxidation states depending on the environment, and shows catalytic activity due to the redox behavior of cerium. It can adopt on a fluorite crystalline lattice structure, which gives it a large reactive surface area for free radical neutralization. As the size of nanoceria decreases, oxygen vacancies form in their lattice structure, causing oxygen defects and serving as a free radical scavenger in the physiological environment. Synthesis of nanoceria. There are numerous methods for the synthesis of nanoceria, such as precipitation method, hydrothermal method, green or bio-directed synthesis, sonochemical method, oxidation method, microwave-assisted method and combustion method. Biomedical applications of nanoceria. Nanoceria has emerged as one of the vital metal oxide nanoparticles due to its wide range of applications in different fields, particularly in biomedicine. Antibacterial activity. Nanoceria has been shown to have effective antimicrobial activity against gram-positive and gram-negative bacteria. Nanoceria cause bacterial cell death via two mechanisms, such as direct and indirect contact mechanisms. In direct contact, nanoceria become directly adsorbed on the bacterial cell, causing damage to the outer cell wall and the generation of reactive oxygen species. The intracellular ROSO generated further damages DNA, RNA, and protein, which ultimately caused bacterial cell death. While in indirect contact, nanoceria interact with the environment, intercellular space, around the bacteria, and the products of this interaction, possibly extracellular generation of reactive oxygen species, further damage the bacterial cells. This indirect interaction mechanism is most common in polysaccharide encapsulated bacteria, those with a polysaccharide layer surrounding the cell envelope, where nanoparticles have no direct contact with the cell wall. So, in this type of interaction, ROS are produced outside the bacterial cell, enter the cell through the cell membrane, and cause damage to the bacterial cells by degrading nucleic acids and protein, eventually leading to cell death. Antioxidant activity. Because of its ability to switch between two oxidation states, Ce3+ and Ce4+, depending on the environment, nanoceria appears to have strong antioxidant activity. This distinct redox property of nanoceria can protect various tissues and organs from cellular damage caused by free radicals or reactive oxygen species. In this picture, you can see the antioxidant activity of nanoceria. Effect of free radical inducers on healthy cells in the absence of cerium oxide nanoparticles, which ultimately leads to cell death. Second one, effect of free radical inducers on healthy cells in the presence of nanoceria, which restores the reasonable condition of the cells. Anti-cancer activity. In addition to antibacterial and antioxidant activity, nanoceria has been shown to have significant anti-cancer potential. It protects healthy cells from ROS while killing cancer cells by inducing ROS formation. Cerium oxide nanoparticles showing pro-oxidant effect in the cancer cell by entering into the cell through receptor-mediated endocytosis and get released into the cytoplasm from the endosome. This acidic intracellular pH favors the SOD mimetic activity of cerium oxide nanoparticles, which reduce superoxide into hydrogen peroxide but inhibits its CAT mimetic activity, resulting in the accumulation of the huge amount of hydrogen peroxide in the cancer cell. These ROS further causes mitochondrial disruption, protein oxidation, and denaturation of DNA, that results in apoptosis of cancer cell. Cerium oxide nanoparticles showing antioxidant effect in normal cell, having physiological pH, by entering into the cell through endocytosis. Drug delivery application. Because of its inherent cytotoxicity toward cancer cells, drug delivery application of nanoceria in cancer cells has a synergistic anti-cancer effect. The cell uptakes the drug at nanoceria coated with a specific targeting agent via endocytosis. Because of the low pH and high GSH in endosomes and lysosomes, drugs are released into the cytoplasm, where they bind with DNA and cause denaturation, or in mitochondria, where they increase the production of ROS, which further attacks the nucleus and causes DNA denaturation, resulting in cell death. Thank you for watching this video tutorial. If you like this tutorial, please share with your friends and colleagues. Thank you.